Good afternoon YouTube and welcome back to the channel. Today I'm in Largs on the west coast of Scotland and I'm going to head a few miles up the coast here to a place called Weems Bay. And when I get to Weems Bay I'm going to jump on a ferry over to one of these islands over here on the left hand side. Now this one here is called Cumbrae or Great Cumbrae. I'm not going to go there, you can get a ferry here to there. I'm going to go to an island called Bute. It's a good bit bigger than this. There's a lot of interesting things to see there. Let's go. Let's cut the corner here. Ooh, it's a bit chilly. It's a nice day though. So the Isle of Bute actually lies 7 miles off the coast here. And the ferry takes about maybe 35, 40 minutes to get to a place called Rothesay. So we're going to go to Rothesay first. As usual, lots of interesting things to see and talk about. Have a look at Rothesay Castle. But there's also other things that we can have a look at on the Isle of Bute itself. As I used to come scuba diving here. Really, really good for nighttime diving. You know, night diving. See big lobsters, stuff like that. There's the slip I used to take. Perfect for a bike. I'm just cruising along here nice and slow, no pressure. There's a ferry coming in right enough. Obviously don't want to miss it. Otherwise, anyway, I think the ferries are every hour actually. What a place. The mountains up ahead, the islands over to the left. Stunning. This is where we want to be. Wow. Ferry traffic that way. Obviously, there's a big boat. This is a railway station. Let's have a look in here. So we are here. I'm going to get the ferry here over to Rothesay. This is a motorcycle lane. I don't know if I'm supposed to park down the front. Let's get a ticket. Okay, so motorbikes. And I guess push bikes as well, first on, which is good news. First on, last off, probably. Strapped in, right at the front. Happy days. Folks, this is the Isle of Bute. Yeah, it's got a population of just over 7,000, about 7,500 people. And this is the main town here on the island, it's called Rothesay. Now just behind me here you can see this old building. Lots of Victorian buildings here, that's one of the first things you notice when you get to the island. But this is actually the museum, and behind that is the castle. Now before we go looking at this castle and stuff, I want to talk about this hill, and this reminds me of a YouTuber. His channel's called Northbound ADV. He lives in North America, California in fact. His name's Forrest. So Forrest lives in a place called Eureka. It's about 5 hours ride north of San Francisco. And he actually mentioned me in one of his videos because he rides around these sort of national parks with the, you know, the giant redwood forests and stuff like that. And he said that here in Scotland we have very, very old buildings, lots of history. He said, well, over in California, they've got very big, very old trees. Now, San Francisco's got a very, very famous street called Lombard Street. It's reckoned to be one of the twistiest streets in the world. But here in Rothesay, we've got Serpentine Street. Back at you, Forrest. Mm-hmm. This is Rothesay Castle. Pretty impressive, huh? Unfortunately, this castle is actually closed for renovation at the minute, because ordinarily you can go inside and have a look around. So the castle here was built around the 1100s by the Stuart clan. And the Stuarts, in fact, would actually become the longest reigning monarchs in British history. So if we look here at the shape of this moat, it's very artistic. It's probably got some kind of defensive purpose, of course. You can see at the back here where they're doing work on this. Now, as you would expect, the original fort was timber built, yeah. And around the early 1200s, the Stuarts actually built this stone fortification, and they added the towers here. Now, the castle was originally here for defence against the Norse and Norwegian Vikings. But later, it became a very important naval base here on the Firth of Clyde for the Kings of Scotland. And in fact, it was in 1371 that James IV, King of the Scots, actually used this as a naval base for the Scots crown. So you see here, this is Serpentine Hill and Canada Hill, 1 mile. A lot of Scots were leaving here to emigrate to Canada for a better life, as it were. So, before they left, those people would come up to the top of this hill for one last look. You know, one last look at the sort of southern highlands of Scotland here before they left it behind forever. And the families would come up, in fact, to watch the, or the people who were left behind would come up, just to watch the boats leaving. Oh, ducks. Wow. Ambushed by some ducks. Wow. What was I saying? Oh yeah. So of course the families, or the people who have been left behind, they would also come up here. Yeah. And this hill here became known as Canada Hill, either for people having one last look before they left, or for the families coming up to see the boats leaving, never to return. Beautiful. What a place. This is the Cowell Peninsula here. Mount Stuart, that's where I'm headed to next. These are Victorian toilets, believe it or not. They're still in use. It's quite a famous attraction here. There's a couple of them actually. I should have put my gloves back on. I figured I'm only riding maybe 2 or 3 miles, but that's beside the point. Apart from the cold, I come off, I'm going to regret it. Oh, look at this church here. I think you can go either way here, actually. We'll just follow the signs. Sort of Tudor-style buildings there. Speed limit's only 15, so should we go slow? Look at these. Through the trees here. Wow. Look at the state of this. What a mess.
Folks, if you come to Bute and you do nothing other than come and visit Mount Stuart House, then you'll have done all right. This is one of the finest Gothic buildings in the British Isles. Now, those are not my words, but you only need to have a look around this place to understand exactly why. It's a Gothic Revival building. So what we're looking at here, folks, is not a castle, it's a house. And it was built for the Marquesses of Bute in the 1870s. And that's because their earlier house here, which was built in 1719, was actually burnt down in 1877. Unfortunately, at this time of year, it's closed, but you can go inside here from the middle of April. I don't know exactly how much it costs for entry, but I think it'd be worth going in to have a look. It's a pretty unique building, to say the least. This was built with the world's first heated swimming pool. Although I think the Romans and the Greeks might have something to say about that. But it was also the first house in Scotland to be powered by electricity. And it's home to the Bute Collection, which is an art collection, but you know, fine arts and silverware. Now, as I say, it was built for the Marquesses of Bute, and it's called Stuart House because the Marquesses of Bute were Stuarts, essentially. You know, they're descended directly from Robert the Bruce. Now, last thing I want to talk about in this building, the library has a collection of over 25,000 books. Look at this building, unbelievable. And amongst that collection is William Shakespeare's first folio. It was published in 1623. So that's a collection of over 30 comedies and plays written by William Shakespeare.
Now within that book, you'll find some of Shakespeare's original classics, such as Midsummer Night's Dream, The Tempest. So easily one of the most influential books ever written. Now, let's go and explore a little bit more of this island. It's getting cold, folks. Look at Arran here. Absolutely stunning. King Garth Hotel. I'm heading towards the sunset, if you don't mind. Now this place is really close to where I live. And I've been to a lot of the islands here in Scotland, but I've never in my life been to Bute. It's a bit of a shame because it's really accessible, it's easy to get to. I'll certainly be back, that's for sure. This is Goat Fell, and these are the mountains on Arran. And then the other side there, we've got the Kintyre Peninsula. Gonna do a little video on that at some point. Kintyre 66. Little loch here. Very nice. That's a beautiful island, right enough. And of course, as we come back towards Rothesay here, we've got a Gate Loch and we've got the Holy Loch, and we're looking across at the Southern Highlands here. So this is Argyll that we're looking at, which of course Bute is, you know, a part of essentially. This is Argyll and Bute.
Across here, you can't see, it's too far away obviously, but this would be Castle Toward here, and up the coast a little bit next to the loch is Castle Ascog. Now these lands here used to belong to the Clan Lamont. Like the MacDonalds of Glencoe, the Lamonts fell foul of Clan Campbell. In 1646, Clan Campbell invaded these lands and they put these castles under siege. Clan Lamont weren't an insignificant clan, but Clan Campbell were huge. They were much, much larger and much more powerful. So rather than a sort of full-blown war, the clan chief Lamont agreed to fair terms for his clan with Clan Campbell. So they laid down their swords and they, you know, they opened up the gates to the castle. So unarmed, they were piled into boats and dragged around the peninsula here to a place called Dunoon. We've got family there. My brother used to live there actually. The Campbells slaughtered over 200 men, women and children round at Dunoon. And on one tree it was said that there was 35 bodies hung there. And 36 men were buried alive. Pesky Campbells, huh? On my next little sort of tour video, folks, I'm intending to head over to the east coast of Scotland, or certainly over in that direction. I've got a few ideas for places I want to head to. Remember when I mentioned the YouTube channel before, Forest at Northbound ADV? I put a link to that actually in my channel description. Why not go over there and have a little look at what he's doing? Maybe subscribe and like some of his videos, that'd be great.